This video is brought to you by Squarespace. Stay tuned to find out how you can build your own $25 gaming PC with the money saved through the sponsorship. What's going on, everyone? It's Ozzy from OzTalksHW. How are you guys doing today? A few days, 2 weeks ago, I was watching some of my old videos and I came across this.
What's up guys, Ozzy here, and over the last few days, I decided to take up the challenge of building a gaming computer with only the money that I had in my PayPal account at the time. Well, at the time, I only had a measly $25. I'm pretty broke. But with...
Oh, fetus Ozzy. So naive. I decided, hey, it's been a minute since I last did an intense budget computer video, so I may as well give it a shot. And since I'm in a new city temporarily, it gives me an opportunity to check out the used market. And man, it's amazing. With a quick skim of local classifieds, I found some fantastic deals, and that was enough to convince me, yeah, I'm totally going to do this. So here's my attempt at a $25 gaming computer in 2019. And let me tell you, I'm not trying to gas myself up here, I promise. It's pretty good. Before we begin, let's take a trip down memory lane and see what the original $25 gaming computer, the OG that started it all, had in store back in 2016. Back in 2016, I managed to create a computer with a Core 2 Duo E4500, 3 gigs of DDR2 memory, a GTX 560 Ti, an 80 gigabyte SATA hard drive, a 600 watt OCZ power supply, and Windows 10. At the time, it provided solid 720p gaming performance and 1080p performance for lighter games like League of Legends and Rocket League. But it wasn't practical, mostly because the power supply didn't fit in the case and it used a dead socket. Fast forward 3 years, and those specs wouldn't cut it nowadays. The PC space looks so different. With 8-core processors sitting under $250 brand new now, dual-core CPUs are obsolete. And with the way that games are trending, it's only going to get tougher. Steve from Hardware Unbox demonstrated this when he compared a Ryzen 5 1600 to an i5-7600K. The 1600, though it was trailing behind a year and a half to 2 years ago, is now beating the 7600K in a lot of newer titles. So, like with anything, I evaluated the current PC space and I made a goal. I wanted a $25 gaming computer, no more than 30 bucks, that uses a quad-core CPU, at least 6 gigs of DDR3 memory, and a GT 1030 level video card. It all needs to fit inside a computer enclosure or case. A cardboard case is an option, but only as a last resort. Frankly, that set the bar high, especially considering I was under intense time pressure to get this done. I started looking at local deals, but most of them fell through, unfortunately. I found an Athlon 2X4 645 pre-built computer with 6 gigs of RAM, which seemed like a perfect fit for what I wanted. It also came with a monitor that I could probably sell and get some money back, but unfortunately, because I don't have a car and the Uber round trip would have been over 40 bucks, I had to decline. With only a few days left to complete the project and a lead lost, I was feeling a little hopeless until I came across this Craigslist post. I swear it was sent from heaven. They were selling a desktop PC and a 22-inch 1080p monitor for 30 bucks total. The monitor alone is worth that much, so I was getting a good deal no matter what. But the issue was, they didn't post any of the specifications, and the seller didn't know the specs or how to check them themselves. I thought to myself, hey, if this computer can utilize 2 USB 3.0 front ports, then it must be at least semi-modern enough, and I have something good to work with. When I got there, I opened the case and I saw a fully custom-built computer.
Oh yeah. So it's one of our old work computers, that's why there's okay. Nothing in it, because I was like,
yeah.
There is no model number, I don't know what it is.
Absolutely nothing was OEM.
Yeah.
It had an Antec 380 watt power supply, an Intel stock cooler, and get this, 8 gigs of DDR4 memory in dual channel, and an LGA 1151 B150 micro ATX motherboard. Needless to say, I paid them the full 30 bucks, took all the gear, and left. On the way home, I made a stop at another seller's house where I picked up the rest of the build. It was a GTX 750 1 gigabyte beefy MSI card that I talked down from $35 to 19 bucks, and then a 320 gigabyte 5400 RPM SATA hard drive. I openly admit this, the 5400 RPM hard drive was a big mistake. I definitely regret it, and I wish I spent another $5 to $10 just to get a 7200 RPM drive or a lower capacity SSD. It would have been so much easier installing and benchmarking, and I would have had a snappier experience. But it kept me under budget. The GTX 750 isn't the most powerful card. It's about as fast as a GT 1030 and has some serious overclocking headroom, especially with the cooler that's on it. I pushed it to 1228 boost clock and a 5710 effective memory clock. It stayed under 60 degrees Celsius during a Furmark run, which means it's pretty much good to go. Furmark. We'll go with Furmark. I'm sure people will get mad about that. When I got home, I was stoked to see exactly which CPU was under the hood. I was expecting like a Pentium or Celeron, something cheap that would work for an office computer. But when I went into the BIOS to see exactly what it was, I was shocked.
This computer with an i5-6600 and 8 gigs of RAM was $30 with a monitor, a 1080p monitor. The heck? This shouldn't be legal. This is unfair. I feel so, like, dirty right now for getting a deal this good. What in the world?
Anyway, here's a recap of the entire build. We have the i5-6600, 2 4-gigabyte sticks of DDR4 RAM clocked at 2133, an Antec 380-watt power supply, a B150 motherboard, an Antec case, and a 22-inch 1080p Samsung monitor for $30 total. The GTX 750 I bought for $19 and the 320-gigabyte hard drive for another $5. Total here is $54, but I'm hoping to sell the monitor for $30 just so I can get the price down to $24. Funny enough, about 10-20 minutes after I was done recording, I actually got someone who agreed to pay for the monitor. So the monitor sold. I didn't get the full $30, but only $25. But that puts this build at $29, which is still under my $30 max. And after some basic house cleaning, the final build looks pretty good. Gaming on the computer was splendid and has so much room for growth. The i5-6600 is a solid CPU, especially at the price I got it, and although the GTX 750 is lacking, it's good enough for 1080p low to medium settings depending on the game you play. But talk is cheap. I'm sure you guys want to see actual benchmark numbers, so here we go. So I'm still a little shook that I was able to build a computer of this caliber in less than 5 days. It's fast, it's upgradable, and most importantly, it is cheap. There are a few things that I learned during this process. One of them is, us Americans, we have it so easy when it comes to finding good computer part deals. I mean, I started this search maybe 4 to 5 days ago, and I picked up all the parts last night. So within 5 or 6 hours, I was able to get this up and running. Secondly, computer technology is advancing rapidly. Just 3 years ago, I had a Core 2 Duo $25 computer, and right now, I've more than tripled the performance. And lastly, and this is more on a personal note, I definitely need to work on my self-control. I've probably bought over half a dozen computer parts locally, and some good online deals within the last like 4 or 5 days. So I will say that this computer project definitely sparked a lot more curiosity and fun searching for awesome computer parts. And just to kind of end my spiel, this wasn't a guide. I don't expect you guys to be able to do this. And I'm not gonna tell you that building a $25 gaming computer is easy, because it's not. A lot of this was luck and great timing. I will say, this kind of helps paint the picture that building a gaming computer for under 200 bucks is totally viable if you are in an area that has some good deals, such as the USA or even the UK. In terms of the future of this computer build, I'm probably gonna upgrade a few more things, such as the awful storage in there, make a cute profit by flipping it, and then call it a day. Now, before I go, I would like to thank the sponsor of this video who helped make this possible, Squarespace. Squarespace is one of the largest website creation and hosting tools ever, and for a good reason. They have dynamic all-in-one platforms where you can claim a domain name, build a website, sell online, and market a brand. You get beautifully designed templates, award-winning service, and solid marketing tools to get the word out. I'm currently moving the OzTalks Harbor website to Squarespace, and man, it's gonna look a lot cleaner than this $25 computer that I just built. So click the link in the description and use the code OzTalksHW for a discount on your first purchase. Speaking of OzTalksHW, that is my Twitter handle. So go follow me and hit me up on Twitter with any cool budget plans that you have, any of your current builds, or if you just wanna chat, talk, have any questions, my DMs are open. So definitely do that too before you click out of this video. If you guys enjoyed it, then make sure you like, share, subscribe, all of that kind of stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.